And God said unto Moses, I am who I am. This Hebrew sentence, Eye Aser Eye, or I am who, which, that, or what I am, is commonly understood to be the root of the very name of God, Yahweh. But what if I told you that this cryptic yet critical verse about God revealing his true nature to Moses could actually be read as, I shall passionately love whom I love. And that to do so, you would need to explore the Midianite roots of Moses' story. Well, let's find out how. Hi, I'm Frederic Spitz. I'm the Parish Administrator here at Saint-Esprit, and I completed a Master in Theology from the University of Strasbourg in 2021. In this video series, Nigel and I share some of the interesting findings and topics that piqued our interest during our research or Bible studies. This particular episode is based on the research by Professor Israel Knoll, as well as Shlomo Dov Goiten. I'll put the reference below if you'd like to read more about this topic. So, in the third chapter of Exodus, God first reveals his name to Moses as the tetragrammaton, or the four Hebrew letter Yod, E, Wav, E, which we usually pronounce Yahweh. A very synthetic explanation of the issue at hand is that Hebrew, like hieroglyph Egyptian and proto-Arabic, do not use vowels. Therefore, the interpretation of such words can be tricky, and we must refer to what the roots mean. For example, if I gave you my name as F or D, would you call me Frida or Fred? If you chose the first one, the etymology of my name would be Scandinavian and would mean beautiful and beloved. If you choose the second one, the etymology of my name would be from the old Occitan, which means cold. Now that I think of it, I think I actually prefer Frida. Anyway, in our translations, the name Yahweh is simply translated as the Lord. But it doesn't mark how important this new revelation of God's nature is. When we read, God said to Moses, I am who I am. He said further, thus you should say to the Israelites, I am, has sent me to you. And we link this to the name Yahweh. But what does that tell us about God? I am sure you have all heard or written a sermon explaining this before. God plays around with the etymology of the Hebrew root for to be, and therefore Yahweh is a play on the word Eye, I am, which he used when he said, tell them I am sent you. The problem is that regardless of how you look at it, it will always feel forced, kind of like a bad pun. So unless we decide that God is bad at creating puns, we have to look elsewhere for the etymology of the name Yahweh. Several biblical scholars, starting with Goiten, have tried to explore proto-Arabic roots to find a better reading of this particular story, proposing a quite interesting nature for Yahweh while explaining the reasoning for this path with archaeological and biblical evidence. We have to acknowledge two things. First, Moses' Midianite backstory. There's no secret here. After he killed an Egyptian, he fled and ended up in Midian. There, he married Zipporah, the daughter of Jethro, or Jether. There's a bit of confusion in the Bible between Midianites and Kenites, and the two seem to be sometime assimilated. But it is commonly accepted that the Midianites were a proto-Arabic tribe, and we know that they were related to the Ishmaelites. This is not only stated in the book of Judges, but you can also see the similarities in the name of Moses' father-in-law, Jethro, sometimes Jether, and the name Jether the Ishmaelites, as read in the first book of Chronicles. Second, the mountain of God is neither in Israel nor in Egypt, but in the Horeb wilderness, near Midian. This pushes us to look for the origin of Yahweh's name in that geographical area, and possibly among the Midianites. As usual, most of our archaeological evidence comes from broken pottery. But to make this short, the archaeological evidence tells us that the Midianites were most likely an Arabian tribe based in the northeast of the Arab Peninsula and that they were involved in the spice trade. In the Egyptian records from the 14th century BCE, there is a geographical list of the people from the southern Transjordan region named the Chassu. The term appears multiple times in the list and means nomadic tribes. The inscription names the tribe that occupies a particular land. This tells us that these different nomadic tribes lived in different lands in the area. One of them is called the Chassou of Yahweh and appears right next to the Chassou of Seir. Again, we don't have the vowels for these Egyptian hieroglyphs, so it could be the Chassou of Yahweh or the Chassou of Yehwah. But naming a land after a deity or a patron wasn't something unfamiliar. For example, Athens was named after Athena. Let's add to this what the book of Deuteronomy tells us. The Lord, or Yahweh, came from Sinai and dawned from Seir upon us. It is therefore quite believable that the Egyptian records meant the Chassou of Yahweh and that it meant a nomadic tribe living in the Midian next to Seir and that they worshipped Yahweh. So assuming that the name Yahweh comes from this area and remembering that Moses found God's mountain while tending the flock of his Midianite's father-in-law, wouldn't it make more sense to look for the etymology of the name Yahweh in proto-Arabic? Well, there's no similar root for to be in proto-Arabic, but the root awaya exists, and it means love, affection, passion, desire. What's interesting is that the use of the letter Vav instead of Yad in the Exodus verse would transform the word to be into passion. Could Eye Aser Eye have been Eve Aser Eve? Not only is it a single elongation of the second letter in Hebrew, but Goitin actually explained that the writing communicated to us could simply be due to a phonetic variation between the Proto-Arabic and the Hebrew. This is not a stretch, since it's something that actually happens in other places within the Hebrew scriptures. So when we read, I am who I am, accepting the phonetic variation between the two languages proposed by Goitin, we should read, I shall passionately love whom I love. And then God tells Moses to say that I love with passion sent him, not I am. Which of the two announcements do you think would most revive the spirits of the children of Israel? Plus, it's not unheard of in this area to have the name of a divinity express the idea of love. Two ancient South Arabian deities come to mind. First, Wud, which literally means love or friendship. Second, Rahman, which means compassionate. But this explanation on the name of Yahweh definitely hits home once you put it in parallel with the verse from the Bible, namely Exodus chapter 34, verse 13 to 14. You shall tear down their altars, break their pillars, and cut down their sacred poles, for you shall worship no other god, because the Lord, or Yahweh, whose name is jealous, is a jealous God. Not only this verse tells us that the name of God is jealous, but it actually tells us that other gods exist, just that they cannot be worshipped along with the passionate one. This concept is called monolatry, and it is different from monotheism. In monotheism, the worshipper declares that there is only one God, as no other God exists. In monolatry, the worshipper accepts that other gods exist, he just chooses to only worship and passionately love one. This comes up again in the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 5, verse 7. You shall have no other gods before me, as well as in verse 9, you shall not bow down to them or worship them, for I, the Lord, or Yahweh, your God, am a jealous God. In conclusion, God reveals his true nature by offering his name. The ancient roots of the word Yahweh could mean that he offers his passionate love, unconceivable to human, what Paul later will call the agape. And he asks, in return, undivided attention and passion, love. This is of course impossible to prove or claim with no possible doubt, but to me, it certainly feels more possible than God making a pun in connection with the sentence, I am who I am. Well, this was quite a tangential video. I hope you liked it, or at least if you hated it, that it made you think. In the meantime, I hope you learned something. Thanks for watching, and I will see you on the next one. Have a great day.